Medical marijuana, the best way for potheads to sound scientific. You see, it's not about legalizing a drug, it's about saving babies from seizures and helping cancer patients cope. It's about the medical marijuana revolution, and it's a load of junk science.
We are in the midst of a marijuana revolution.
A certain strain looks to be very effective in treating kids with severe seizure disorders.
A mystery compound believed to have healing properties.
Let's get this out of the way right now. I have nothing to say about whether or not we should legalize recreational marijuana. That's a discussion for politicians, not scientists. The question here is whether marijuana should be viewed as a medication, and it shouldn't be, because it's dangerous, it's untested, and it's unethical. So far, 23 states and Washington, D.C. have all legalized medical marijuana for select diseases and conditions, despite the fact that marijuana has never been proven safe or effective in any sort of large, randomized clinical trial. You know, like every other medication. Take epilepsy, for example.
I'm Dr. Sanjay Gupta.
In 2013, CNN reported that Charlotte, a small child suffering from constant crippling seizures, was saved by marijuana. Despite the fact that this was an isolated case, it led to nationwide calls to deregulate medical marijuana for Charlotte. And then the studies started rolling in. 1 year later, a massive literature review concluded that not one single reliable study has ever shown that medical marijuana is even safe, let alone effective, for people with epilepsy. The American Epilepsy Society now officially recommends against medical marijuana. But that didn't stop 17 states from approving medical marijuana as a treatment for epilepsy, in defiance of the best available research. And the junk science is only spreading. 20 states have already approved marijuana for cancer and AIDS patients with nausea or loss of appetite, despite study after study showing that conventional drugs work better for managing both symptoms. Before we use old men with Alzheimer's and little girls with epilepsy as guinea pigs in some misguided social experiment, it pays to put marijuana through the same rigorous tests and trials as any other medication. Right now, that's impossible due to federal laws prohibiting such research, but that's no reason to make up science and put people at risk. At least for now, if anyone tells you that we're on the brink of a medical marijuana revolution, that's junk science.